Good evening, everybody, and thank you for joining us. This is Gil Leyvas up in Sky 5 along with my pilot, David Viskovich. We're over a pursuit that started in the Compton area. It's been a while now. It's at least an hour-long pursuit. This is a reckless DUI driver. That's what the Compton sheriffs got behind this vehicle and determined it was a reckless DUI driver. They tried pulling him over on surface streets in Compton, and the vehicle took off on them. On surface streets for a while at a slow rate of speed, then started to ramp it up, going wrong direction on the roads, on the streets there in Compton, in different directions. Eventually, the Sheriff's Department pulled off of the pursuit. Now the CHP's on it. We're down here in Laguna Hills right now on the 5 freeway southbound. It basically came from Compton, went down the 710 freeway to the 405 freeway, then it went south from there. Going all the way into Orange County, into Costa Mesa, jumping onto the 73 freeway and taking that toll road for a while until it got off on surface streets, going through Irvine, and that's when the CHP picked it up on surface streets. During that time, the car was driving recklessly, high speeds, wrong side of the road, at one point coming into an intersection on the far left-hand side of the street. That would have been the westbound lanes of the street it was on, and cars turning right, not even knowing the vehicle was there. But something was just tossed out of the vehicle right there. I'm not sure what that was, but the driver, as I push in here, we're going to look and show you a shot of the driver while the window's down. The driver, been, like I said, driving recklessly. The CHP picking up the pursuit probably about 6 minutes ago, like I said, in Irvine, and it came onto the 405 freeway southbound, has since merged onto the 5 here southbound and is continuing through Laguna Hills. You can see the speedometer here that we have. Looks like 50, just under 55 miles an hour. And as I zoom out, you'll see the freeway. Not a lot of traffic on it because the CHP and trail there is blocking lanes, keeping traffic slow at this point behind it. But at this point, the driver failing to yield. They've been talking about doing a pit maneuver on the vehicle. Even the Compton sheriffs were talking about it early on in the pursuit when the car was driving slow on the surface streets. But now the CHP has an opportunity here with open lanes, no traffic around, to do that, although the speeds are just a little bit too high for that pit maneuver. Just a few minutes ago, we watched the vehicle come to almost a complete stop on the freeway and then take off again. So this driver definitely playing cat and mouse with the CHP at this point and not worried about being reckless at all, going on to opposing lanes at times on surface streets. So at this point, we are still southbound in the carpool lane here. Laguna Hills is the locator, and continuing to drive. Looks like he's picked up some speed, about 70 miles an hour, and I'll come back wide again to give you a shot. This driver looks like he has the entire freeway ahead of him because he was going slow, because the CHP had slowed down traffic behind him. Now he's starting to catch up to cars that are entering the freeway here on the 5 south. We got construction through this area, and that can be a problem. We saw the driver at one point run over some traffic cones during the pursuit. Again, the one on this is a reckless DUI. That was the Compton sheriffs that initiated the pursuit. It went through Compton, parts of Linwood, and then made its way back to the, eventually to the 710 freeway, jumping on the freeway there. It was around the 105 freeway, or I'm sorry, the 91 freeway, and then made its way down to the 405 southbound. We've seen the driver roll down the window at times, just a couple, maybe a minute or so ago, threw something out of the vehicle. But right now, it's kind of hard to see through those windows that are tinted. I'll come back out to a wide shot to show you what's going on the freeway. Not a lot of traffic southbound here. And CHP keeping their distance. It's unclear what the reason for the distance is. There was no word on any kind of weapons in the car from the, at least from the Sheriff's Department of Compton. But for some reason, they are definitely keeping their distance from the driver right now, but still in pursuit. All across lanes here, might be exiting. Let's see what happens. And he's in the exit lane there, definitely through the gore point. So we're getting off the freeway here. This is going to be Crown Valley, and we're going to see some cross traffic here. He's going to make a right turn away from the freeway. Westbound on Crown Valley now. Right through a red light there. CHP slowing down briefly for that red light as I zoom out wide here. Still westbound, and he's merging in to cut that car off, going into that gore point there in the street. Now he's going to make a U-turn. Oh, no, look at this. Oh, wow, right across those vehicles there through the intersection. It looked like he was maybe clearing himself through that intersection there by doing that, using the crosswalk basically to make sure there was no one coming, and then cross through the intersection on that red light. And now coming to a stop under the bridge here, we'll see what happens. Nope, still creeping along. Again, a little cat and mouse under the bridge. Window down. They're asking for permission to do a pit maneuver on this. We'll see if that happens, but slow speeds will definitely allow them to do that. Here we go. Let's see if they move in on it. We got a motor officer there. Also, there's the California Highway Patrol helicopter. And here comes the pit. We'll see it happen right here. Here goes. Boom. Hits him. Spins him out of control. That might do it. Let's see what happens. Nope. He's going to bail out now. He's going to bail out. He's angry. He looks angry. That's it on the pursuit. He is not exactly complying. He jumped out, looked a little angry, taking his shirt off, and not complying. The unit there, there's a unit there with a canine, not complying, facing the officers. They're going to want him to maybe go to the ground or turn around, walk backwards to them. But a perfect pit maneuver spins the vehicle out here. This is Crown Valley at Cabot Road. And now he's complying. Hands up, walking backwards. That's exactly what they want him to do. Well, look at that. He's smashing something on the ground there angrily. Not sure what that was. And now he's going to comply. That's good. Down on the ground. And that's going to do it. It looks like they're going to come in cautiously on him, handcuff him. A long pursuit from Compton here all the way to Laguna Niguel. Now they're going to check the vehicle, make sure there's nobody else in there. Well, the driver slowed down enough for the California Highway Patrol to do their pit maneuver. It was well done in a perfect spot, no traffic, wide road, slow enough speeds. It was just enough to get that car disabled, spin it out of control. The driver jumping out with the car still moving, rips off his shirt, pretty angry it looked like, and then finally complying. So at this point, the driver in custody. No other injuries to speak of, but a lot of close calls in this pursuit as the driver was reckless through many areas of the streets that he drove in or drove on. And now they have him in custody. They're clearing the car. They're looking in the car. It might be locked. Nope, they got the door open now. So they're going to evaluate what's going on inside the car. It looks like it's clear.